Let's be honest, physics is tough work, and it can be confusing. The first time I took physics, I think I understood a bit of it, but a lot of it remained beyond me. Now, as I studied physics, lots of it began to make more sense, and the same thing will happen for you. As you continue to learn about physics, it'll start to make more and more sense. But there's one area of physics where this rule is violated, and that's quantum mechanics. No matter how much you study quantum mechanics, it doesn't really ever make sense. Let me explain why. In quantum mechanics, we learned that particles behave like waves. That's weird. You probably are like, what do you even mean by that? Don't worry, we'll get to that. So particles behave like waves. That's strange, and it never makes sense. It's never like, oh, I get how that's possible. It's just always a little mysterious. It gets even weirder, though, because particles, like electrons, behave like waves. But as soon as we look at them closely, as soon as we detect them, they behave more like particles. It's very strange stuff. The quantum world is bizarre. Let's learn about it. Let's begin by reviewing our lesson objectives. First, we'll introduce the principles of quantum mechanics. We'll talk about the wacky way the quantum world behaves. Then we'll introduce the applications of quantum mechanics, how we can take advantage of these wacky rules to do cool things. All right, well, let's begin with the principles of quantum mechanics. First up, particles sometimes behave like waves. That is a wacky thing to say. What does it even mean? Well, recall that waves interfere. So in our unit on waves and their interactions, we talked about how when peaks and troughs of two separate waves overlap, they make a bigger wave. We call that constructive interference, when two waves combine to form a larger wave. On the other hand, if peaks and troughs overlap, as shown here, these two waves combine and suddenly we don't see any wave at all. That's called destructive interference, when two waves combine to form a smaller wave. Now, the classic way to show that light is a wave is to do the two-slit experiment. Here we have a light source, so imagine a laser shining a light forward and hitting two slits. These two slits cause two separate wavefronts to come out. We see those two separate wavefronts overlapping, and when they overlap, they interfere, much like two water ripples overlapping. And that gives us this characteristic interference pattern. Notice it goes green, red, all the way down. The red spots are bright spots where there's lots of light, and the green spots are dark spots where there's no light at all. So this interference pattern tells us that there's constructive and destructive interference going on. So waves produce interference pattern. Well, where our story gets crazy is that if we repeat this experiment with electrons, so now we have an electron source shooting out electrons, again hitting two slits, where the electrons hit is perfectly predicted by an interference pattern. The bright spots mean lots of electrons hit there, and the dark spots mean no electrons hit there. So electrons produce interference patterns? That's bonkers. So in this case, we see the electrons behaving like waves. The second principle I want to highlight is that measurement changes things. Traditionally, when I measure the temperature or speed of something, I don't really change it. Or if I do, I change it just a little. That's not true in the quantum world. In the quantum world, measurement changes things entirely. Now, when we did this double slit experiment with electrons, one question people had was, well, which slit did the electrons go through? If they only went through one slit, then there should be no opportunity for interference. So let's put on detectors, which we have represented here in purple, and they're just going to tell us which slit the electron goes through. When we measure which slit they go through, they only go through one slit, as you might expect, but then the interference pattern goes away. Now what we see is very much what we'd expect if we just threw golf balls at two slits. They pile up just on the far side of the two slits. So with measurement, the interference pattern is gone. That means measurement is doing something crazy. Before measurement, electrons behave like waves. After measurement, electrons behave like particles. That's wacky. That's quantum mechanics. But measurement has some more interesting properties in the quantum world. For example, the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, named after Werner Heisenberg, says that we can't perfectly know the location and speed at the same time. What does that mean? Well, let's think about it in terms of an analogy with your car. You can know your location in your car. You do that with your GPS. And you can know your speed. We do that with the speedometer. And of course, we can just know both of those. That's no problem. But in the quantum world, we only get to choose one. We can use our GPS or we can use our speedometer, but we can't use both of them at the same time. and know exactly where we are and exactly how fast we're going. That's pretty crazy. So we can't perfectly know the location and speed at the same time. The third and final principle I'll highlight is that energy is quantized. What does that mean? Well, again, let's return to our car for an analogy. Your car can go any old speed. That's what the speedometer says. It can go 0, 1, 2, 3, or any speed in between, apparently all the way up to 100, though I kind of doubt it. But a quantum car couldn't do that. It could only go specific speeds. So maybe it can go 0 miles an hour and not move at all. And then if you give it a little energy, you hit the gas pedal, it goes immediately to 30. It can't go anywhere in between. It cannot go 10 miles an hour. It cannot go 11 miles an hour. And then maybe you hit the gas a little more and it goes to 70. These speed jumps would be what is called quantized. So here its speed is quantized. What does that mean? Well, quantized means not continuous. So instead of going smoothly from one speed to another, we have these hops, skips, and jumps. Quantized means discrete. Let me give you an example of something that's continuous. Here is a rainbow, a spectrum of all the light. It shows us all the different wavelengths in the visible light. That's nice and continuous. Contrast that with this set of light. It's discrete. It shows us only certain specific wavelengths and not others. Well, there's no surprise that this discrete spectrum of light is actually connected to quantum mechanics. This is the light from hydrogen atoms. So if we give hydrogen atoms energy, they'll emit light, but they won't emit all light. They'll emit red and teal and purple. That's kind of strange. Hydrogen atoms only emit certain colors because of quantum mechanics, because their energy is quantized. So, three things to know about quantum mechanics. Particles sometimes behave like waves because they lead to interference. Measurement changes things. So we see that when we measure electrons, they go from waves to particles, and we can't know position and velocity at the same time. And lastly, energy is quantized. Well, how can we take advantage of these strange rules? What are some applications of quantum mechanics? First up, take the sun. What is the sun made of? Maybe you know, but consider how hard it is to know. We haven't visited the sun. We can't go stop by. It's a little too hot. In fact, in the 1830s, Auguste Comte said this: "We shall never be able by any means to study the star's chemical composition." That seems like a reasonable claim because you can't visit it. So how are we going to know what it's made of? The trick is quantum mechanics. Quantum mechanics predicts exactly what light different elements emit. And it turns out the sun is mostly hydrogen. We use a tool called spectroscopy, and spectroscopy shows us what stars are made of. Quantum mechanics is at the heart of spectroscopy. Next up, we use it for display technology. Have you ever seen a QLED TV? Well, that stands for quantum dots, light emitting diodes. So these are light emitting diodes that are based on quantum mechanics, and we can pick the lights our TV emits using the principles of quantum mechanics. Another fantastic application of quantum is quantum computing. We are just starting to be able to make very small quantum computers, and they can do calculations in a whole new way that'll let us solve all sorts of new problems. Let's put your knowledge to the test. Determine if each claim about quantum mechanics, here abbreviated QM, is true or false. So pause the video, read each claim, and say whether it's true or false. Go ahead. All right, now let's go through them one at a time. Quantum mechanics applies to the very small. That's true. So all of the strange principles we've mentioned about how measurement changes things, about how particles behave like waves, about how energy is quantized is true only of the very small world. At the large world, things behave pretty much like we expect. In quantum mechanics, a particle can be at any energy. That's false because remember that energy is quantized in quantum mechanics. That means it can only take on certain specific values, kind of like rungs on a ladder. All right, particles can behave like waves. Well, that's true and wacky. D, we don't know what stars are made of. False, we do know what stars are made of, and we know from spectroscopy, which is a tool developed by quantum mechanics. E, in quantum mechanics, location and speed can be perfectly known at the same time. That's false. According to the uncertainty principle, we get to choose one to know pretty well, and the other one's going to become less and less certain. Let's review what we've learned. First, we introduced the principles of quantum mechanics. We said that particles sometimes behave like waves, and that measurement changes the systems we study in crazy and unpredictable ways. Lastly, we said that energy is quantized, which means it can only come at certain discrete intervals. Then we introduced the applications of quantum mechanics. We talked about how spectroscopy lets us study the composition of stars. We talked about how QLED TVs use quantum principles to create displays of light, and how quantum allows quantum computing. Hey, hey.